lesson is all about the external angles of polygons. Let's start with the sum of the exterior angles. Now we find an exterior angle by extending one of the sides out to make a ray, and then you draw that little angle on the outside of the polygon. Now those exterior angles can keep on going all the way around the polygon. I drew them all around clockwise, so you have all 8 of those exterior angles. And if you think about an ant just walking around that polygon, you'll notice that it went in a circle. It's 360 degrees. The sum of the external angles is always going to be 360 degrees. Now, you can go ahead and draw that counterclockwise if you want. I'm going to go all the way around the same figure. Those exterior angles on the other side are still going to add up to 360 degrees. And that makes it very simple. So don't get that confused with the interior angles. You just always say that the sum is 360 degrees. But what about the measure of an exterior angle of a regular polygon? Remember, regular polygons had the same angles all the way around, and we just want one of them. Well, you're going to take the sum, 360, and divide by the number of sides. It's that simple. Don't overthink this. It's always going to be 360 degrees. Divided by how many angles there are. So for this octagon, we take 360 degrees, divide that by 8, and we're going to get 135 degrees. Very simple, 135 right there on the exterior. So let's see how this works on a six-sided figure. Let's start here with this hexagon. We'll draw an exterior angle right there, and it's 360 degrees. All the way around that polygon. And to find one of those 6 angles, we just take 360 degrees and divide by 6. The number of sides is the number of angles. It's 60 degrees. Now let me show you a shortcut. Notice this interior angle right there. Well, together, those two angles make a straight line. They're supplementary. They always add up to 180. So you don't have to use the formula to find an interior angle. You just take away the exterior angle, which is very easy to find, and subtract from 180. For this, it's going to be 120 degrees. It's much simpler than the formula for interior angles. So just an extra shortcut.